Professor Keith Moore is one of the world's prominent scientists in the fields of anatomy and embryology, and is the author of the book entitled The Developing Human, which has been translated into 8 languages. The book is considered a scientific reference work and was chosen by the Special Committee in the United States as the best book authorized by one person.
In the 1940s, Professor Streeter of the Carnegie Institute of Embryology in Washington, D.C., proposed a system for classifying the stages of human development. His system arranged human embryos in 23 numbered stages based on their differences in appearance. The Carnegie system of classification was used around the world until the 1970s, when a more refined system was proposed by Dr. Ronan O'Reilly of the Carnegie Institute of Embryology, now in San Diego, California. Intensive studies of the Quran and Hadith in the last 4 years have revealed a system for classifying human embryos that is amazing, since it was recorded in the 7th century AD. Although Aristotle, the founder of the science of embryology, realized that chick embryos developed in stages from his studies of hen's eggs in the 4th century BC, he did not give any details about these stages. As far as it is known from the history of embryology, little was known about the staging and classification of human embryos until the 20th century. Stage is adapt, and you'll have to apologize my pronunciation. This is from Surah Tariq 6. He is created from a drop emitted. This Arabic term refers to the forceful emission of fluids, which occurs during ejaculation in the male and ovulation in the female. The male secretions, called semen, contain the spermatozoa, and the female secretions, called follicular fluid, contain the ovum. This is the stage of fertilization and the nutva, and after this is what we call the zygote, referred to in the Quran as the nutva, and the nutva undergoes division, which we call cleavage, as it passes down the uterine tube. So these are the stages of the nutva here as it undergoes cell division.
Another important aspect of the information mentioned in the verses of the Quran is the developmental stages of a human in the mother's womb. It is stated in the verses that in the mother's womb, first the bones develop, and then the muscles form which wrap around these bones. We then formed the drop into a clot, and formed the clot into a lump, and formed the lump into bones, and clothed the bones in flesh, and then brought him into being as another creature. Blessed be God, the best of creators. Embryology is a branch of science that studies the development of embryos in the mother's womb. Until very recently, embryologists assumed that the bones and muscles in an embryo developed at the same time. For this reason, for a long time, some people claimed that these verses were in conflict with science. Yet, advanced microscopic research conducted by virtue of new technological developments has revealed that the revelation of the Quran is word by word correct. These examinations at the microscopic level showed that the development inside the mother's womb takes place in just the way it is described in the verses.
Obviously, life begins at the moment of fertilization when a single sperm fuses with an ovum to form a one-celled embryo or zygote. At this moment, the ultimate character of that new individual is decided. The Quran recorded these facts 1400 years ago.
Staging and classification of human embryos until the 20th century. For this reason, the descriptions of the human embryo in the Quran cannot be based on scientific knowledge in the 7th century. The only reasonable conclusion is that these descriptions were revealed to Muhammad from God, from God, from God, from God.
Then we made the sperm drop into a clinging clot, and we made the clot into a lump of flesh, and we made from the lump bones, and we covered the bones with flesh. Then we developed him into another creation. So blessed is Allah, the best of creators.
فالمركزية جاءت واخد براحتها في الاتجاه العلمي. بمعنى ايه؟ ان هم لما طلعوا في الفضاء وصوروا فلقوا الارض كرة معلقة ومظلمة، ولذلك حتى الراجل قال ايه؟ اجدها كرة مظلمة معلقة، من الذي علقها؟ هو يريد ان هو أرمسترونج، وكان كأنه يريد ان يقول بلسان الحال لا بلسان المقال الله الذي علقها. ووجدوا فيها شعاع يخرج
من الأرض،
من الأرض، كتبوه في الشبكة العنكبوتية في الإنترنت وخلوه على مدى 21 يوم ثم أخفوه.
أخفوه لماذا؟
يعني الأمور تتبع يعني
مقاصدها،
مقاصدها يعني،
يعني إخفاؤه دعنا نقول إنه له دلالة، مثلا
له دلالة كبيرة جدا. لسبب، لأن هذا البيت العتيق، يعني هم لما جم ولقوا فيها شعاع، لقوا الشعاع ده قصير الموجة، لما لقوا هذا الشعاع ابتدوا يركزوا الصورة فوجدوا أنه خارج من مكة، وبالتركيز وجدوا أنه خارج من الكعبة.
الله،
هذا ما ذكر.
وله تأثير؟
ووجدوا أن هذا الشعاع ليس له منتهى، يعني لما طلعوا في المريخ قعدوا يصوروا فلقوا الشعاع مستمر، فقالوا أن طول الموجة اللي احنا عارفينها أو قصر طول الموجة اللي احنا عارفينها، هذا الشعاع له خاصية محددة.
تمام.
وهو أنه مستمر لأسباب، لأنه كما أعتقد أنه يصل هذا الشعاع أو يربط الكعبة المشرفة بالبيت المعمور. لو أنت عندك قطب شمالي قطب جنوبي، في النص في منطقة اسمها منطقة التعادل المغناطيسي.
تمام.
لو حطيت فيها إبرة مغناطيسية لا تنحرف،
يعني السحب هنا وهنا واحد.
أيوة، يبقى دي بيسموها منطقة الزوال المغناطيسي التي ليس لها فيها خطوط قوة مغناطيسية.
تمام.
ودي عشان كده اللي بيروح مكة، اللي عايش في مكة المفروض يبقى أطول عمرا وأكثر صحة وأقل تأثيرا بالجاذبية الأرضية. وبالتالي عندما تطوف أنت تشحن، معلش
سبحان الله،
هي هذه حقيقة،
هذه حقيقة للبعد للبعد عن
لأنك أنت لا تؤثر فيك المجالات المغناطيسية الأرضية في هذه الحالة. وهناك بحث أن صخور مكة البازلتية السوداء هي أقدم الصخور الموجودة في العالم، هذا كلام حقيقي،
أقدم الصخور. أيوه. وهذا أثبت علميا،
أثبت علميا وبحث منشور، وليس
أخذوا يعني صخور بازلتية من مكة،
بازلتية من مكة وشافوا المناطق اللي بتتكون لنا. الأمر أنه المتحف البريطاني فيه ثلاث شرائح من الحجر الأسود، وقالوا هذا الحجر ليس من صخور المجموعة الشمسية،